Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Aaron. If you're new here, thanks for stopping by. And if you are a current subscriber returning to watch my videos, I do appreciate it. So, the trailer for John Wick Chapter 4 dropped, and so I'm here to react to it.
Wow!
John Wick Chapter 3 left off on a very interesting note. Now, obviously, there's the next chapter, which is John Wick Chapter 4. I like the John Wick franchise. I think the first one is the best, although I gotta say the third one is the best in terms of overall action, even if it's overkill. So I'm just wondering how crazy they're gonna go as far as action and violence. The trailer is almost 3 minutes long, so let's stop talking about it and let's check it out.
Saying goodbyes?
Saying hello.
You think your wife can hear you?
No.
Then why bother?
Maybe I'm wrong.
You're going to die.
Maybe not.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend.
A new day is dawning. New ideas, new rules, new management.
We've known each other since we were 9 or 10.
Who is this?
The Marquis de Grammont.
Challenge him to single combat. Win or lose, it's a way out.
I don't sit at the table.
Your family does.
Please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family.
A man has to look his best when it's time to get married. Or buried.
I'm going to need a gun.
Goodbye, my friend. It's hard to die.
If you win, the table will honor its word. You'll have your freedom.
Under the old laws, only one can survive. Failure to meet at sunrise will result in execution.
Last words, Winston?
Just have fun out there.
I want you to find your peace, but a good death only comes after a good life. You and I left a good life behind a long time ago, my friend.
Let's start today.
All right, I gotta say, that trailer was great. Music was great. The scenes they decided to use in the trailer I thought were great. The colors are great too. I thought it was a fantastic trailer. What I love about the John Wick franchise is I love that there's more going on than just assassins. Like, whole high table, all these rules that they have, codes of conduct they all live by almost like 100% of the time. I find it very interesting, like this whole secret society of the best assassins in the world. And if you watch the third movie, or maybe it's the second one, they are literally everywhere. Like, everywhere. Like, some of it is so outlandish, but it just, for some reason, it works. I think the first film was going for more of a little bit more of that realistic. I don't think that's a word. It was going for more of a realistic, there we go, kind of story with a little bit of exaggeration, and then it worked, so they did the second one with more exaggeration, and that worked. The third one they went crazy with, and that worked. Now they have the fourth one, which looks like it's just off the rails insane. But it works for this franchise. You can sit back and enjoy the violence. That sounds awful. But you can sit back and just enjoy these films without laughing at, like, it being B-movie quality type of thing, because it's not. And Keanu Reeves, I think, is perfect as John Wick. Honestly, I can't picture anyone else playing this character. It just works for him. Minimal dialogue. Personally, I don't think he's great at dialogue. So, minimal dialogue, great action. He does almost all of his stunts, and he puts 100% into being this character. You watch the behind-the-scenes videos. He's insane. So, most of what you see in this franchise, where you're like, oh, that's so unrealistic. It is, but at the same time, it's not, because he's a real human being at 50-ish years old actually doing this. It's quite amazing. I think this is the first time we see John Wick use nunchucks, which is cool. They look ridiculous in movies when you use them, but from what I've heard, they're extremely effective if you know how to use them properly, which obviously he does because he's a master assassin. There's scenes in rain or maybe sprinklers, like from the ceiling because of a fire or something. Who knows? But I always thought that scenes in the rain are very interesting, especially if it's a fight scene. I think it just makes it visually more intense. So I loved that. It's getting to the point, though, I gotta admit that it's so over-the-top ridiculous. He and Donnie Yen at the end of the trailer are like shooting and blocking bullets with samurai swords, you know. It looks cool. It does kind of throw back to certain films with, what's the word they use? I don't remember the word. I'll put it up somewhere in here if I remember it. I think it's Gun Kata, they call it. And you see it in that film. What was the name? Wow, my mind is running a blank. You see it in this film with Christian Bale. That's where it was really, like, kind of popularized. Wow, what the f***? That was where it really became more popular in American movies, and we still don't see it a lot. So to see it in this, kind of using it, it looks cool. I think it'll be great, but they have so, like, left the station of realism. But you gotta accept it and just watch it and enjoy it, which I'm sure I will when it comes out next year. Alright, so what are your thoughts for the trailer for John Wick Chapter 4? Are you as excited as I am? Leave your comments below. Let me know what you think. As always, if you'd like this video and subscribe to my channel, I would very much appreciate it. Thanks for watching. I hope you come back and see me in another video. Goodbye.